The first day of May brings us out to the CSX Selkirk subdivision. With temps being in the mid-70s, I knew it was going to be a perfect day. Here we see I-007 coming out of Selkirk's west end to continue his trip west to Rose Lake, Illinois. After meeting up with our friend David, we race over to the river line at 117 to shoot 567. Destined for Wallbridge, Ohio, he heads to Selkirk where he does work and then points west. Right after Q567, we head back to Game Farm Road on the Selkirk sub to catch an eastbound entering the yard. Still unfamiliar with the train IDs, I have no idea who this guy is. Right after this eastbound, the bells and lights got my attention as a westbound was coming out of the yard. About 45 minutes passed, and here comes the next westbound. I believe this was Q627. According to a few railfan pages, plans were to have CN3115, the BC Rail Heritage Unit, be trailing on this train, but plans changed, so we saw this lone ET44 and a mid-train DPU instead. Thank you. What is usually a daily occurrence here on the Selkirk sub, and something that I've never seen before, is a race coming out of the yard. Hot on his heels on 627 is Q567, meaning he had no work to do in Selkirk today, so he had a crew change and then continued his trip west.
after these two westbound trains cleared Game Farm Road, me and David had to part ways, so I figured it was time to go back to CP-117 to catch a few more northbound and southbound trains. The next northbound that would be coming up on the river line is Q-434. Leading today's train is an ES-44AH, and right behind him is one of three Pride of Service units built by CSX, CSX-T-3194, which is the Honoring Law Enforcement Unit. Right after Q-434, we hang out for a couple more hours to catch I-004 coming south out of the yard. In a few seconds, you're going to see this big error I had when I was filming I-004, and I will explain why in just a second. If you leave your Bluetooth on, it'll connect to your car and start playing music and somehow stop recording. That is what happened to me. as soon as I-004 clears 117. Figured we'd chase him down the CP90 as we get a good shot at him again. But due to slow drivers and a lot of red lights, I missed him by 10 minutes as I heard him call clear 85 south. So we set up camp at 90 instead, as we wait for 212 with 8907 sitting in the third seat. Hope you enjoyed today's video. If you did, leave a comment, give it a thumbs up, and subscribe to my channel for more content. Until I see you again trackside, this is Ulster County Railfans, out.